Hi again. Thanks for bearing with us through that. That'll be the worst one, I promise you. There's 117 kids on stage behind me. The only difference between this and a marching band is a drill page. So thanks for hanging out. I have a list on my computer. It's actually three lists, and I have the next 5 years of clinicians lined up for honor band at any given point. And so, you know, Mr. Peacock came up, and he was the number one choice for the year. We were really excited to get him. And the gentleman behind me, to my right, has been on my list since I started creating the list back in 2014. And I am really excited to have been able to get him to the Delta to do our honor band. I actually have figured out in the last 2 days when I met Brian. He doesn't remember this probably, but it was in the middle of the summer and I was still living in Virginia, right outside of Manassas, with Paul Fadul. Yeah. He showed up and we talked band for about 4 hours, and I was in my second day of teaching. And we've known each other off and on since then. I have been educated beyond words by some of the things this dude can do with a band. And these guys have had a heck of a couple of days working with him. Brian is, and I said this when I introduced him the other night, and I mean it absolutely from the bottom of my heart, Brian is the best teacher I have ever had the opportunity to watch. And these guys have benefited from that in the last couple of days. It's been really fantastic to watch him work with these guys, and I'm really excited to hear the concert. I cannot be more excited to introduce Mr. Brian Thomas from Justice High School in Virginia to you.
Oh, I wasn't nervous before you said that. We're going to get started this afternoon with a march called Marche, Dibolique. I have to say this too, my mind gets so entrenched in music and what these wonderful young people can do, especially over the course of 2 days. So in case I forget, and I may say this two or three times, but thank you for everyone who's hosted us here. The staff here and Dr. Richard Beltis, the students, oh my gosh, the students, tuba players around the world around here. We have Peyton and Matthew, and it's made such a wonderful time. Thank you, parents. Thank you, directors. It's been a wonderful time getting to know you. And if I say this again, just think, I'm thinking music, right? So without further ado, here is the Symphonic Band with Marche, Dibolique. Thank you. Bizarre.
It's not the cock shop, sir.
That was a tuba timpani duet, Julie. The next number we're going to perform here is two movements. So if you'd hold your applause to the very end, it's called Songs of Old Kentucky.
Thank you.
Gabriel Fauré. Many of you may recognize it. It's Pavane. This piece for band is very tricky. I've only done it with a band of maximum, I think, 35. So, we have a large band in front of us, but I hope that you hear the subtleties of this piece and you hear the beautiful melodies that most instruments have in here. I hope you enjoy it for Gabriel for yourself. Come on.
Thank you.
once again, I think it's wonderful that we can come together. I think it's been said already over a weekend and do this. Kids from different schools, directors from different states, and come together to make music in this short amount of time. These students have done a remarkable job at coming together and blending and balancing and working on intonation. There's so many things we worked on this weekend. And I hope that you take a lot of these skills back to your band rooms and you talk about them with people who aren't here, right? Because if we just keep it to ourselves, this thing about music, if we just keep what we do here to ourselves, it serves a purpose for the day, but then it's over. I like to think that music lives on, okay? Music is always evolving, living, changing, being shared. So the things that you've done here today, the things you've heard the middle school do, things you'll hear the wind ensemble do, things that we've done, I hope that you take these elements and take this excitement and this skill, all of you, back to your schools and continue to grow. Yes? That makes sense on the weekend, yes?
Yes.
Okay, the last number we're gonna perform for you is a piece by a well-known band composer from, I almost hate to say this, like 50 years ago, 30 years ago. I wasn't in high school 50 years ago, but 35 years ago I was. And Alfred was a big name in the band world. And so I wanted these students to have this experience. It is for a big band, so we have a big band here, and I hope you enjoy this Alfred piece, Imperatrix.